Beautiful people on YouTube, I hope you are having an amazing day. In today's video, we are going to dive inside of my computer so I can show you how to set up and structure your Amazon PPC campaigns. If your Amazon PPC campaigns are not set up properly, you will end up with very unsatisfying results and you can potentially lose a ton of money. Before we dive into structuring our Amazon PPC campaigns, you first must understand each of the types of campaigns and what the campaigns can do for your Amazon FBA products. So first we have an automatic campaign. Automatic campaigns are used to gather organic keywords that our customers are searching when they are shopping on Amazon. So every single time a customer clicks on your ad through a specific keyword that they typed into the Amazon search bar, you will see the keyword that they typed in if they clicked on your ad. The next we have is a manual campaign. And manual campaigns come in broad, phrase, and exact. A broad manual campaign are keywords that are loosely matched. So if we are going to use an example here, let's use the jade roller as an example. So let's pretend I am selling a jade roller, and some broad keywords for jade roller can be jade roller for face, roller jade, or jade roller woman, or jade roller facial. These are all broad keywords. If I were to run just jade roller and put this into a broad manual PPC campaign, these are all the different types of keywords that may appear because they are loosely matched broad keywords. Phrase keywords are a little different. So if I put the keyword jade roller into a phrase match type manual PPC campaign, I may end up with keywords such as jade roller for men, jade roller green, rolling jade roller. When you have a phrase match type PPC campaign, the keyword jade roller will be together, and these are all the phrases that may appear when customers are searching for your jade roller. So there are so many different types of broad keywords and phrase keywords, but that is the difference between the two. For broad keyword, it's more loosely matched. So I will add another example here. This could be jade for face, because jade roller doesn't have to be together, whereas a phrase campaign, jade roller has to be together because it is a phrase. Exact match type keywords are exactly that keyword. So if I run a manual PPC campaign for an exact match campaign, it will just be jade roller or jade roller with an S. So if I put jade roller into an exact manual PPC campaign, I will get just jade roller and nothing else. No broad keywords, no phrase keywords. And then finally, we have product targeting campaigns, which are also ASIN targeting campaigns. This means we are targeting our competitors' ASINs, or we are targeting our other product ASINs if we have other variations or products that complement our main product. So let's say I am selling a green jade roller and I also have a red jade roller. Maybe in my red jade roller product listing, I may want to product target my green jade roller so the customer can see that product as well within my red jade roller product listing. Just in case you don't know what I mean by that, if I go into my green jade roller listing and I product target my red jade roller as well, my red jade roller will end up right here. Products related to this item, and I can put my red jade roller anywhere here. And if this is my red jade roller listing and I want to product target my green jade roller, I can do that here as well by using product targeting campaigns. Now, don't go and source a jade roller. This is a very, very bad product. I am just using it as an example today. If you are brand registered with Amazon, you have a lot of other options, such as headline search ads, sponsored display ads, and you can do a lot of other fancy things by using Amazon PPC under sponsored brands and sponsored display. We will not dive into that today. But now that you know the differences between all of these campaigns, we can now talk about structuring your campaigns. If you want a step-by-step tutorial on how to set up each of those campaigns, then I suggest you watch this video right here where I break it down step-by-step. But today, I only want to go over the structuring part of this, because the structuring part is where it messes up a lot of Amazon sellers. So let's pretend I am creating a PPC campaign. I'll click on continue right here. One thing you guys have to understand is that when you first create any PPC campaign, you have to be doing things right in terms of structuring. So if I were to create an automatic targeting PPC campaign, this has to be checked off. You put your campaign name in here, but what is most important is that you should start with only one ad group within your automatic PPC campaign. So if you are creating an automatic campaign, let's pretend I'm creating this one, and I want to test dynamic bids down only, I may select this option, and then I will add my product and set the default bid and then create launch campaign. After you do that and you go into your automatic PPC campaign, you will have one ad group right here with your automatic campaign. Now, some sellers make this big mistake that really messes up the organization of their PPC campaigns. They will create ad group right here, and then with this campaign, within this campaign for this ad group, so this is a separate ad group from the one we just created, they will come in here and select a different product. They will select a different product and then set the default bid and then click create ad group. You should not be doing that. You should always create a different automatic campaign for each one of your products. If you are mixing products into different ad groups in your automatic campaign, your daily budget is not going to be allocated properly. So if I were to go back, if I have multiple ad groups here and they all have different products or variations or whatever the story is, you are going to soon realize that your daily budget is not going to be allocated across all of those ad groups for whichever reason you are creating ad groups. So what you should be doing is having one ad group per product. Same goes for manual PPC campaigns. So if I were to create a manual targeting Amazon PPC campaign and I want to do broad keywords, phrase keywords, exact match keywords, a lot of sellers will click on manual targeting. They may select a campaign bidding strategy. And here is where we will create one ad group. So you will rename your ad group. And the biggest mistake here is selecting multiple products or going down here and entering broad phrase and exact match keywords in one campaign. And that will really mess things up. So if I enter my keywords here, and I put in jade roller and I add these keywords, this will go for broad phrase and exact keywords. Three of three keywords don't have suggested bid. Okay, whatever, let's just add that. If you do this, this is going to be very messy and you won't know which types of keywords are working best for a specific campaign. So what I like to do is separate these three in their own campaigns and not put them into one. And of course, if you have multiple products, if you have a green jade roller with a broad campaign, that should be in one campaign. And then you have a red jade roller with a broad campaign, that is in a separate campaign. When you start adding a lot of ad groups, like I said, you again will realize that your budget is not going to be allocated across all of those ad groups. And this is when sellers tell me, Tamara, I am not getting any impressions or clicks for my other products or my other keywords or whatever the case is? Well, that's because your daily budget is probably not being allocated across all of those other ad groups. Now, I'm not saying that ad groups are horrible and they are bad. Sometimes, very rarely, they do make sense. The only time when I will go in here, this is my manual broad PPC campaign, the only time I will create multiple ad groups within a broad campaign or a phrase campaign or exact match campaign is if I want to sort out different search volumes for my product. So let's pretend I am running a broad PPC campaign and I am targeting keywords that have between 1,000 to 5,000 searches per month on Amazon. I may create one ad group for that. And the next ad group may be a higher search volume, maybe 5,000 to 10,000 keyword searches. That way you can separate them through keyword search volume. So that's just an example reason on why Amazon sellers may use multiple ad groups. The main takeaway here is that just remember your daily budget will try to spend across all of these ad groups. And if you have way too many ad groups or way too many keywords within a campaign or way too many keywords within an ad group, your daily budget will not be able to spend across all of those keywords. Which brings me to my next point, having too many keywords per campaign and having too many keywords per ad group. That will slow down your launch and cause you to slow down on getting organic keyword data and slow down your sales in general because you have way too many keywords and you only have 24 hours in a day. So it's a little hard for beginners to kind of wrap their head towards, but what I want you to think is you have 24 hours in a day, and if you have too many keywords or too many ad groups within a one campaign, how do you expect to spend that amount of your daily budget across hundreds of keywords? It's just not going to happen. So for example, in this broad manual PPC campaign, I only have 5 keywords. In most of my manual PPC campaigns, I won't add more than 20 keywords unless I have very low search volume keywords. I may add up to 50, but that would be it. If you are targeting low search volume keywords, then yes, you can add more keywords. But if you are targeting any main keywords or any very specific type of keywords that have average or high search volume every single month, by the way, you can use Helium 10 to check how many customers are searching for a specific keyword if you want to find out search volume. But the more keywords you add, the slower it will be for you to get any momentum through using your daily budget. So this is when you kind of have to do some testing and figure out, okay, how many keywords should I add to one campaign? But I don't want you to lose your mind over this. A good rule of thumb to follow is to have about 10 to 20 keywords per manual PPC campaign, and you should be good. If you need more of the same campaigns, let's say you want more broad campaigns or phrase or exact match campaigns, I would just create a separate campaign and target different keywords under that campaign. You don't want to stuff hundreds of keywords within one campaign. Make sure you are downloading the advertising search term reports as well to check how many keywords you are actually getting through a specific campaign. A lot of the times we make the mistake and just look at the data here and we try to make a decision, but it's really hard making a decision off of the campaign manager, because if you are running an automatic or broad or phrase campaign, there are so many longer tail keywords that don't show up on this dashboard. So you have to download this search term report and then bring up your Excel file and really check out, are you getting any new keywords? Which keywords are bad? Which ones are good? Which ones should I put into the negative? And make sure that things are moving along and that you are getting data. I suggest you to watch this video right here where I talk about optimizing your Amazon PPC campaigns. After you learn how to structure and set up your campaigns, The fun part is optimizing your campaigns. You have to know when to remove certain keywords, when to add new keywords, etc. So check that video out so you can optimize all of your Amazon PPC campaigns. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Please help me give this video a huge thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and I will see you guys in my next video.